sa kagegurui masho. Hey girls, what's up? It's the Culture Detective here, investigating your favorite animes. And today I'll be reviewing Kakegurui Season 2, or for some reason called Kakegurui XX. It is a manga written by Kawamoto Homura and illustrated by Naomura Toru, adapted into an anime by MAPPA Studios. I just reviewed Season 1 not too long ago, and Season 1 is surprisingly not bad. Not at all. It's insane, it's eccentric, it's also entertaining, and has some likable characters. I enjoy it quite a bit. And then we have the second season, of course. To recap, welcome to the Hyakkao Academy, where everyone gambles to gain power, and most people cheat. Yumeko, literally a gambling addict psychopath, joined the school and defeated a few student council members. And the student council is the most powerful group of students, by the way. We have some notable characters like Saotome Mary, who had a redemption, Suzui, the innocent, naive boy, Sumeragi, the spoiled rich girl, Midari, the absolutely insane, sexual, suicidal girl, and Kirari, the horrifyingly cold-blooded and inhuman, super-duper powerful and rich student council president. Also, a Yumemite, the idol girl, who's also like gambles to gain power and stuff. Yeah, let's start off by talking about the OP. Wow. Such a letdown. It's a huge letdown. It's a great disappointment. The OP, this one, is nowhere near as good as the first season OP. It doesn't have the unhinged energy of the jazzy deal with the devil that is the first OP. Instead, this one is so much more stale and typical and basic. The animation is okay for the most part, except for the parts where the characters actually lip sync to the song. Seriously? Really? Yeah, the more times I look at that OP, the more I think it's just cringy. Having the characters lip sync to this song, especially characters that we don't even know yet. Ugh. And then as far as the ED goes, I actually think it's a little bit better than the first one, but it doesn't mean that it's all that great or anything. So, we have episode 1, which is a pretty lackluster opening, honestly. We immediately jump into the middle of a gamble between Yumeko, Midari, and some other girl with pink hair. And since we know practically nothing, this game wasn't really all that interesting, even though it seems pretty crazy at first. We rewind back in time to see a group of brand new characters just walk into the student council room, and I don't mind it when the writer wants to introduce new characters, but by throwing a bunch of new characters in the story, it's a kind of a lazy way to expand the story. Essentially, these characters are all from the same clan of the Bami family, so their last names are like Inbami, Jabami, Momobami, Renbami, whatever Bami, and they're supposedly super powerful and weird. Then towards the end of episode 1, we have a 3-minute long montage of scenes from season 1 with the OP of season 1 in the back, as if there isn't already a recap earlier in the same episode. Episode 2 is basically the second half of the gamble that started the season. It has some cool moments, but overall, kind of forgettable still. On episodes 3 and 4, Yumeko and Suzui were up against the Inbami sisters, and it was actually pretty entertaining. It's the first time in the story where Yumeko literally gets poisoned halfway through and passes out, and then Saotome Mary has to replace her and win for her. Holy shit. And that's great because Saotome Mary is a really likable character and I like seeing her on screen. It's just a bit baffling that Suzui is still an innocent, naive boy even though he clearly had a change at the end of last season. The face and the personality of the vice president of the student council is also revealed and it's actually pretty interesting. I still hope that her character is more layered, but I kind of like that the vice president is beginning to develop feelings for Mary. Episodes 5 to 6 go over Yumeko and Yumemite, the idol girl, versus a Hollywood actress? And honestly, I have mixed feelings about these two episodes. It seems very stupid at first. Why would a Hollywood actress suddenly show up out of nowhere and decide to gamble on a stage? And the gamble is not really a gamble. It's just idol contest. It's a singing contest, a macaron eating acting contest where you have to eat a spicy macaron, but you can't let your opponent know. Also, another gamble. Also, another two episodes where it's just singing and dancing again. But on the other hand, I kind of like that Yumemite's character is developing and becoming more and more fleshed out. There's also a cool plot twist regarding one of the characters, but the twist could have been shown way more shockingly. It also ended in a wholesome way, which is cool, but isn't it already done before? Yeah. Then we have episodes 7 and 8 where Terano, the short-haired, wheelchair, powerful, determined girl, organized a gamble for Yumeko Sumeragi, the nails girl, and the rude boy and the white-haired girl from the Bami clan, and then Yumeko also appointed another player that is Manyuda. Yes, the super smart boy whom Yumeko had defeated in season 1. The game is essentially trying to spot the traitor among us. Everyone will be given 5 coins and they can either put it in their personal bank or the tax box. If they put it in the tax box, the coins will be doubled and will distribute equally among the 5 players. Episode 7 was kind of slow, and there are a few moments that were unnecessarily dramatic. Also, the characters are just not that well written. That rude boy basically acts like a yakuza, like a gangsta, and the white-haired girl is pretty boring. The first scene where Sumeragi took care of Manyuda in the hospital was a total mess of emotions. But episode 8 is certainly more entertaining. We have some awesome twists and turns. It's also very satisfying to see Manyuda picking back up his gamble spirit again. Also super satisfying when Sumeragi had a plan of her own. She acted so normal the whole time. Turns out it was all part of her plan, not even Yumeko's plan, and that's pretty cool. Also, there is a bit of comedy in that episode, like in the middle of that episode, which is pretty funny, and I always love it when a super serious show that takes itself kind of seriously. Well, this show is not super serious, but it takes itself pretty seriously. But whenever it has a moment of comedy, it's always a nice moment. Over to episode 9, where we have Sayaka, the secretary of the student council, who had a huge crush on Kirari, the student council president. But Kirari likes Yumeko, so to fight for her love, Sayaka decided to gamble against Yumeko. And even though the gamble isn't even a friggin' gamble, it's just a straight-up problem-solving, like, math thing. And worse yet, it's so overly dramatic and unrealistic. This is also very, very entertaining. Kirari brought the two girls into a tower of doors. They start on the 5th floor and they have to work their way to the ground floor and then go all the way back up. There are doors to stairways and ladders and the outside, but to open the doors they have to solve a puzzle problem, like a math problem. Each one of them have 5 minutes until another person's turn. Episode 10 is also really memorable for me. Throughout the whole episode, I just felt really, really, really bad for Sayaka. Why did she decide to gamble against Yumeko, knowing that it's friggin' Yumeko? She's destined to lose, but yet she went so far because she's just so devoted to loving Kirari. And the ending is also really satisfying and wholesome, and it didn't give Sayaka a bad, embarrassing look at the end, which is pretty nice, I guess. Then we have the last two episodes, episodes 11 to 12, where Yumeko, Suzui, Mary, Riraki, Midari, and a slit-eyed girl were invited to an auction. Again, not much of a gamble, more of an auction. And it were two very confusing and crammed episodes. The auction is where they could bet votes just to buy votes, because I forgot to mention this, but in episode 1, the reason why the Bami clan showed up out of nowhere is because they wanted to participate in the election of the student council president. Because the student council president wanted to give everyone else a chance to be the student council president. So everybody's receiving votes and stuff, and but the only way to actually give votes to someone is by gambling, of course. And then we have this auction thing, where you can buy votes by betting votes. I don't know why. It's very counterintuitive. But essentially, someone is sponsoring these votes, and these votes will go to this sponsor. But then at the same time, the sponsor will also give out votes. I have no idea why did they decide to do this auction thing. We see Batsubami Rei, who has been one of the more interesting characters in the season, who's actually not a psychotic, greedy, crazy person, but a kind person who believes that gambling is bad. And then there's a twist regarding her, and on one hand, I like that the anime is trying to give her more layers, and on the other hand, I'm just kind of disappointed with this plot twist because it just kind of ruined it for me. The second half of the auction, aka the final episode, is also kind of confusing, especially how it kind of ended with a coin toss, like no game, no life. Both also very underwhelming. And for some reason, this coin toss resulted in a win-win situation for both Yumeko and Rei. Also, apparently this is anime only. This arc doesn't even exist in the manga. So overall, Kakegurui Season 2 or Kakegurui XX is a bit of a letdown. Don't get me wrong, it still has the psychotic, sexual, insane energy that I really like, but at a few points it began to be a bit redundant and overly dramatic for its own good. But I think the worst part is that the writer just decided to throw in a bunch of new characters when it's a way better way. It's a way better idea to develop the already existing characters. Still, I enjoy some of the gambles, some moments are still really entertaining. More characters are explored like Sayaka and Rei, but it's just a bummer how Tsuzui acted in the season 1 finale. He kind of reverted back on this season. Also, I would like to add a couple of things. First off, the election results were actually announced from time to time in the season, and the wheelchair girl Terano and Kirari, the former student council president, are always the top two. And we just don't get to see why. Like, they never actually interacted with the public. We don't know how are they getting all these votes. I mean, other than gambling, of course, but we never see Terano actually gamble anything. And we did see Kirari gamble a little bit, but not enough to convince me, oh, so this is why she's still on the top. And also another thing I would like to add is this show is almost taking itself a little too seriously because it's just so dramatic, it's so crazy. I would really, really love to see if this, I would really, really love to see this show sort of make fun of itself a little bit, maybe have a few more comedic moments, because I was watching the last two episodes and in my head, I was just making jokes. Not because it's laughably bad, but I just realized how desperately the show needs comedy. But yeah, I guess I'm just gonna leave it at that. My favorite is episode 10, and my least favorite is probably episode 1. I'm giving Kakegurui Season 2 or Kakegurui XX a decent to strong 6 out of 10. Yeah. So, have you watched Kakegurui XX? From 1 to 10, how much did you rate it? Like it, and subscribe if you want more, and thanks for watching. I think I will watch Bakemonogatari as my next anime, that or ID Invaded. And I will for sure watch some, you know, 2020 animes, because I actually kind of want to make the top 10 animes of 2020 list. So I'll probably watch, you know, like Dorohedoro, Gleipnir, Akudama Drive, Kaguya-sama 1 and 2. Yeah. Jujutsu Kaisen.